We will use two different coordinate systems in this course, Cartesian and polar. The Cartesian coordinate system is the one most people are familiar with that involves x, y, and z coordinates. The polar coordinate system involves r and theta coordinates instead of x, y, z. The purpose of these coordinate systems is to define locations and distances. To help describe these two systems, I'll work through a couple of examples. So here's a coordinate grid showing x and y axes. The z axis isn't shown. It's the third dimension pointing out of the screen. Usually in physics 1, we can get by just talking about two dimensions, so just the x and y coordinates. Notice the units for each axis are defined in parentheses next to the x and y axis labels, so meters in this case. Also recognize that the positive direction for each axis is from the origin toward the axis label, and the coordinates for the origin are 0, 0. Okay, let's clear the grid and work through an example. First, I'll mark through a location and designate it A. Where I've placed location A is 7 meters along the positive x-axis and 4 meters along the positive y-axis. In Cartesian coordinates, then, the location of A is 7, 4 meters, where by convention we write the x component first and the y component second. If we were writing all three dimensions, we would write the z component third. Now let's write the location of A in polar coordinates. R is the radial distance from the origin to the location we're describing, A in this case, and theta is the angle measured from the positive axis to the radial R line. Given the x and y coordinates, we can find the r and theta coordinates with trig. Start by making a right triangle. You can see that r is the hypotenuse and the other sides are the x and y components, 7 meters and 4 meters. We can then calculate r with the Pythagorean theorem, which comes out to be 8.06 meters. We can then find theta with the inverse or arctangent function. This gives us an angle of 29.7 degrees. We can now write the location of A in polar coordinates. 8.06 meters, 29.7 degrees counterclockwise from the positive x-axis. By convention, theta is measured counterclockwise from the positive x-axis, though, as we'll see in the next example, it doesn't need to be. For the next example, let's place location B here. B is located 4 meters on the x-axis and negative 7 meters on the y-axis. With that, we can write the location of B in Cartesian coordinates, 4 and negative 7 meters. To find the location of B in polar coordinates, we start by drawing a right triangle where this is r and this is theta. Remember, by convention, theta is measured from the positive x-axis counterclockwise to the radial r line, so that's why it sweeps all the way around like this. So let's start with r. The sides of the right triangle are 4 and 7 meters again. So using the Pythagorean theorem, we again get that r is 8.06 meters. Now let's calculate theta. It's easy to make a mistake here. To get it right, I recommend that you first calculate the angle inside the triangle, say here, which I marked with a phi, and then theta is 360 degrees minus phi. We can find phi with the inverse tangent of 7 over 4, which comes out to be 60.3 degrees. Remember that the tangent of an angle is opposite over adjacent, so that's why I wrote 7 over 4 instead of 4 over 7. Also notice that I didn't use negative 7, because in this approach, we're just applying a trig function to a triangle, and the lengths of the sides of a triangle are just positive numbers. So now that we have phi, we can calculate theta by recognizing that it is 360 degrees minus phi, which comes out to be 299.7 degrees. We can write the location of B in polar form now, 8.06 meters, 299.7 degrees counterclockwise from the positive x-axis. So, as I've said, the convention is to write the angle counterclockwise from the positive x-axis as we've done. However, It's often referenced in other ways for convenience, such as in this case, 60.3 degrees clockwise from the positive x-axis, where I'd use the angle phi, which is 60.3 degrees. Or we might reference the radial R line to the negative y-axis in this case, which would be this angle, I'll call beta. We can see from the picture that beta is 90 degrees minus phi, which is 29.7 degrees. So the polar angle might be written this way, 29.7 degrees counterclockwise from the negative y-axis. The last thing I want to talk about is how to determine the distance between two locations. As an example, let's find the distance between A and B. Let me start by clearing the grid. Here's the distance we want to find. What we'll do is use lines parallel to the axes to make a right triangle this way, or we can make it this way. It doesn't matter which way. Next, we want to determine the lengths of the sides of the triangle. It may help to visualize it better with these guidelines. You can probably tell by inspection that these are the lengths involved, and so the lengths of the two sides of the triangle are 11 meters and 3 meters like this, and we can calculate the length of the hypotenuse with the Pythagorean theorem, which comes out to be 11.4 meters. And so this is the distance between A and B. An equation to calculate the distance between two locations can also be derived from the method we just found. Skipping the derivation, here's the equation that you can use to do this, where AX and AY are the Cartesian coordinates of location A, and BX and BY are the Cartesian coordinates of location B. So let's apply this equation to locations A and B from the previous example. Remember, these are the Cartesian coordinates of the two locations. And now plugging these values into the equation gives us the same answer we got before, 11.4 meters. As a mathematical detail, notice where we plugged in negative 7, we then get 4 minus minus 7, or 4 plus 7. That's basically it. The last thing I want to mention is that there are two worked out examples on Moodle dealing with Cartesian and polar coordinates. And so that brings us to the end of the video.